My name is Gabe Zepeda. I'm a production quality specialist here at Astranis. And I dropped out of college to work at SpaceX. You know, I took a risk. Everybody's like, degree this, degree that. And I just was thinking like, if I'm gonna use this time on Earth to do anything repeatedly, day in and day out, it's gonna have to be for something that's bigger than me. So SpaceX was like a no-brainer. Let's make our species multi-planetary. Let's really increase our access to space. And I feel the exact same way about Astranis. I mean, we're doing work that is essential to advancing humanity. It feels the same way SpaceX did in the early days. All right, so when I started back in 2012, it was wild, like Wild West. You walk around the lab and you hear all of this ringing, and you'd be surprised how effective a mallet is putting rockets together. Yeah, it is. It's called mechanical agitation, and it's a very good method for getting things to fit. But it was like in that transitionary period between let's get the rocket working and then let's get certified for like NASA flights. So there was a lot of tribal knowledge, long hours, but that's when I learned the most, because that was when I had more face time. I actually sweat more with the engineers who were teaching me how to do what I didn't know at the time. Before that, I was doing like part-time school, odds and ends jobs. I think I was like 19 at the time. I just applied for as many jobs as I could at SpaceX because my thinking was like foot in the door and then move around from there. I probably applied for like 8 different jobs. There was things like line cook, general helper, janitorial stuff, and the one that I knew I was probably not gonna be considered for was the propulsion technician apprenticeship. Because I was like, my technical background, it's not good enough for aerospace, right? I'm this 19-year-old kid. Yeah, I remember distinctly watching over the course of a few days, all of those jobs just get denied, denied, denied. And I was like, there's no way this is gonna happen, right? I'd lost all hope. They emailed me back and they were just like, hey, take this test. And it was a little like logic test. This gear moves this way. How does the last gear move? And like, this is to this, that is to that. I took the test and I had only missed like a couple of questions. So like the very next day I got an email and they were like, hey, come on site for an interview. You know, I remember showing up and like seeing very established people getting out of their cars with portfolios and like blazers. And I'm like, what am I doing here? It was my turn. And dude walks in with like board shorts and like flip-flops on a Saturday. He's like, what's up? Your resume isn't that decorated. He's like, do you have experience with like cryogenic systems? I'm like, no. He's like, what about high pressure like testing? I was like, no. And he's like, well, what experience do you have, right? And I'm like, well, that's what I want to learn. And he's like, okay, well, you know, you're not that qualified. And he's like, is there anything else you want to say? And something came over me and I was just kind of like, you know, I do want to tell you what will make me different than anybody else you'll talk to today. And it was that I actually wanted to be there for the mission and what SpaceX was doing, making civilization multi-planetary, not for the money and not for anything else. You know, and he's like, oh, okay, I'll take that into consideration. About a month later on Christmas Day, they gave me a call saying that I got the job. Cherished moment was I was flown out to the Cape to work on a rocket that was up for launch. It was one of the coolest things I've ever done, really, because after that, I really had a moment where like I walked out of the building to cross to the launch pad. You know, it's the same launch pad that all of the Apollo moon missions left from. There was something surreal about standing on the same concrete that other humans left the Earth to go stand on the moon on. Yeah, how many people like can share that, you know? And I felt really, really like, I felt connected, you know? And I felt like I was contributing towards civilization in a way. It felt good. It was kind of spiritual in a way. And that's kind of, I think, probably the undertone of like my career path has been like, it's been spiritual in a sense of, oh my God, this is gonna get really crazy. So I was born and raised in Downey, California. I don't know if you knew this, but the Apollo command capsule was designed and built in Downey. When I was old enough to understand what that meant, blew my mind. It was a big, open, just like industrial area. And I remember always asking my parents, what used to happen there. And they're like, oh, the space shuttles were built there. We'd always drive by there. Just like looking at the old abandoned warehouses with the windows that were blown out. And like, there was an overlay of my imagination of just like a bunch of space hardware moving in and out of there. And it was like always in, like, I used to daydream about it. I think I did internalize, like, how do I leave something like that behind? It's hard to really articulate that because it wasn't like, okay, I want to go and work in the space industry. It was more of a driver of like, how do I make my work live longer than me? So a few months ago here at Astranis, we launched the first block of satellites that I worked on. It's just crazy because like in that moment, it became real. I'm like, I'm gonna pass away at some point and something that I touched is gonna continue drifting through space for an eternity. And that was when I was like, holy crap, I left my mark in the universe. It's an untapped source of energy for me. I don't wake up dreading coming to work, you know? When I started at SpaceX, we were in the middle of a transition from Falcon 9 version 1 to Falcon 9 version 1.1. Currently at Astranis, we're going from block 2 to block 3, and it is identical. It feels the same. That's one of the things that really excites me here, because I get to spend like my whole workday working on making our processes much more efficient and scalable and just of higher quality, you know, repeatable, predictable, you know. There's a lot of like process changes that need to be made. There's a lot of procedures that need to be optimized. There's a lot of controls that need to be put in place. There's a lot of design changes that need to be implemented. These are all the things that need to be done to take Astranis from a good company to a true disruptor. Definitely stoked to help Astranis reach the next level. I feel like it's what all my career has been leading up to. You know, all those positions that I held at SpaceX, all of those lessons that I learned, all that experience that I gained, I feel is like coming to a head here, and I finally get to be super effective with all that stuff. Is it really a gift though? Oh shit, did you get this custom made, dude?
Yo, what?
No way, dude. How did you do that? My name is Gabriel Zepeda, and I am a production quality specialist here at Astranis.